Welcoming everybody and good evening. And this is the big Train World virtual train show. And thank you everybody for joining tonight. We really appreciate it. And last night was the first night of the big virtual train show here at Train World. And it was great. We had some great guests, great support for the Amherst train show. So it was a really nice time. A lot of DCC stuff, magazine companies. So it was just action-packed and including new product, tons of new product. And tonight, it's going to be more of the same. Just some great guest companies and just more new product and all the stuff that you normally see at a train show. And I know it's a tough time where we can't actually be at a train show, but hopefully this will kind of bring a little something to your home, and we'll do our best to keep you entertained for the evening. And how about you, James? Got any recap?
I don't have any little quips like that, but the first day was very exciting and had a good time talking to everybody, getting a little backstory from John from the Amherst show about just the history of the show, some of the behind the scenes. I didn't get to talk to a lot of the manufacturers about some things they had up the pipe coming out, like mostly sound decoders was the theme of yesterday. And today we'll be talking a lot about G-Scale, I hear, and HO as well. So look forward to what we have tonight.
All right, sounds good. And why don't we just go around the horn? And we'll introduce ourselves. I'm Ken Jr. from Train World. The co-host is James Wright, JLWII2000. We have Ryan Kunkel from Lionel. How you doing, Ryan?
Very good. Great to be back here again.
Gail and Stacy from LGB.
Hello.
Hey, Ken. Good to see you again.
Good to see you guys. Larry Harrington from Bachman.
Hi, everybody. I'm behind the banner here.
Andy Edelman of none other than MTH Electric Trains.
How you doing, Ken? Good to be here again. Looking forward to tonight.
Sounds good. Jonathan Metter, Pico Trains.
Hi there. How are you?
All right. Jim from Athern. New face.
Yeah. Hey, Ken. Thanks for having me on board tonight.
Sounds good. Thanks for coming, Jim. And Angela Trotta-Thomas, how you doing, Angela?
I'm doing great. I'm happy to be here.
All right. So tons of companies, definitely a lot of product, tons of slides, action-packed. Stay tuned. We're going to kick off this segment with the G-Scale portion to start, and we'll kick it. We'll start it off with LGB, Gail, and Stacy. Come on down, Gail and Stacy. Hold on, let me unmute you. There you go.
All right. We're going to share a video first from our friends in Germany.
On Thursday, we just had our big new products announcement for the new year, and Germany put together a really great video that we're going to share with you, highlighting some really fun new things from LGB.
First time sharing, so you know we're just learning and doing this.
Well, I'll start it while you're figuring out how to share the screen. LGB has announced their new catalog, and they have a ton of new items. So if you haven't saw how to what new items there are, we actually just listed it online today. So we'll be did you get that, Gail?
I got your part.
Okay. So we're taking pre-orders now. Tons of new product.
We're going to step it into.
Stacy, while Gail's trying to figure that out there, what LGB stuff do you have on display?
what we have on display, and later Gail will use our central station to show you sounds, but this is the brand new Coca-Cola Mogul. It's in a really fun red and yellow paint scheme. It's iconic. It used to be, they used it in a truck design way back when. And then we have the Piste de la Resistance. We have the new Santa Fe engine that finally came in. This is the real thing, the chrome model. You remember there's nearly 40 steps to get the chrome plating. It's not a sticker or paint. It's actual chrome. It's perfect for outdoors in any type of weather, except for maybe some ice.
Yeah, and that Coca-Cola steam mogul that you guys got there, we actually just got those in stock, and the sound features are really cool. I think it actually plays the an American theme song. I think it's either the national anthem, but and it's also got the Coca-Cola quenching the thirst. Really cool.
Yeah, it's very fun.
We can play you some sounds real quick. That was a bottle opening.
That's what Kim was talking about. But...
very cool.
There's more.
Did you all crush your hearts?
There are those 1/29th scale. Is that right? Everything you guys do is
122.5.
Huh?
22.5.
Or 122.5. Okay. I'm still learning G scale, so I know
we are too.
28 is like one gauge at 132, so I was just trying to figure all that out.
And we got a good question about the cogwheel locomotive, and that's actually going to be coming in hopefully in a couple of months, but it's still not out yet. But
doesn't like my sharing, Ken. Here, we'll go to our catalog. Oh,
there you go. You're there.
This is really exciting. It's the 50th year of Amtrak. It it came out when a transitional time. People were moving away from passenger trains, going more towards cars and plane travel. But Amtrak wanted to keep that alive. So LGB is celebrating that with an AAB unit and a full set of cars. So Gail can flick through the pages. Mm-hmm. No?
Yes.
So there's an A unit. Oops. Another A unit.
Just details. The B unit.
We work closely with Amtrak to make sure that the logos and where Amtrak was listed on the train were correct.
Very nice.
Yeah. Two different road numbers for the A's, of course.
Now it's a special year for Amtrak, too. It's their 50-year anniversary.
Yep. Dome car, which is very important. And then you have the end car with a lighted drum head, which is typical for LGB. And then to go along with the Amtrak line, we have a little diesel switcher engine if you don't want to go with the F7 ABAs.
This is somewhat of a fantasy model, but people love it, so we'll keep going.
And then we're excited to introduce, click to the next page, a mogul, the Durango and Silverton. They're making a nice quantity of these engines. We've been asked to rerun the mogul for a long time, so this is a good addition to the line. And there's two cars, if you go back, that go along with this engine. We also still have some Durango and Silverton passenger cars in stock that also go along nicely with this car. And then something we're really excited to introduce is not figures. It's the other way. Nope. Oops.
It's so exciting. It's flashing for you.
The UP track cleaning engine. Nope. Is it flashing for them?
I don't know why it's flashing.
That's it.
Yeah, we're having a hard time seeing that, but that engine that you're trying to bring up is actually beautiful looking. It's a G-scale track cleaning locomotive that's powered, and it has the UP logo, but also with the American flag. So really nice looking engine.
Always very popular, but this paint scheme's very, very nice.
Yeah, I think that will really be a tremendous pre-order piece. And James, you may have to pick up on this one.
Well, my wife's going to kill me since I just spent an ungodly amount of money with you on other G-scale stuff. We ordered like 5 engines yesterday.
Very cool. Very nice.
And then we also, there are 3 new figures being reintroduced that never can have enough figures on in your trains and on your layout. I'm just going to go to the crocodiles since you can't do the video. You don't want to do the crocodiles? The other thing that LGB is doing this year, it's the 100th year of the Swiss crocodile.
I don't think we're sharing. Hold on. You don't see that, Ken, do you?
No. But just to extrapolate on the crocodiles that you're talking about, I'm hearing from the serious collectors that they want this piece. Usually LGB once a year comes out with like the high end creme de la creme every year, where people just, whether you're in Europe or America, they just need it to collect. And there's a blue version and I believe also a brown version. Just really nice, beautiful looking. And I expect the collectors are really going to go crazy over this one. And
those two are both high-end models, so they're metal. But LGB also came out with a brown one in a different road number that's a plastic model that's more reasonably priced. So you can either go high-end or you can do a traditional LGB version. And then there's all the cars that accompany the crocodile as well. So there's really nice offerings.
These will be hot as well, Ken. They're already hot. Almost sold out.
Wow. That's great. And we had a good question from, I don't even, Kaya and John, is the full Amtrak available as a set? They're separate pieces, but you could buy them individually to create a set, but no track and transformer on those. But a lot of nice stuff, great Amtrak pieces. A lot of people are going to want to collect them. And, you know, those crocodiles, too, are going to do very well.
We're just going to play some noise for you just for a little bit so you can hear the great sounds in case you aren't able to share there. It's just a sample.
Very cool.
All new sounds, all new decoders on the F7s this year. With the Chrome, we figured we probably ought to do something better than we did in the past. So with the Chrome, and that's what we did here.
That's great. And you guys forgot the most important part, the Christmas car.
We don't have one yet. Oh, it's in the catalog.
It's in the catalog.
Christmas car. Order today, they sell out. Oh,
hold on. I got it coming.
Sets that are like just ready to run sets where it's like modern freight or modern locomotives in a set, or have you thought about doing that?
Doing what?
do you guys have any ready to run sets, like for a starter in G-scale that would have like a maybe an F unit locomotive and some, you know, rolling stock that's a little more modernized, or are they all kind of individualized items?
I think the dollar figure for that would be pretty scary for a lot of people.
But
we've talked about it in the past, but it always comes back to the dollar figure.
Donald wants a F unit in New York Central. That's a really nice looking Christmas car. Every year we sell out, so make sure you get your pre-orders in. That will be a really good piece.
And we'll have some other Christmas stuff, Ken. It's just this is what we have to show you today.
So. Very cool.
All right, sir.
All right. Thank you, Gail and Stacey.
I got the video.
Yeah, you're going to have
to. I can send it to you.
So we could post it at a later time.
Okay.
We'll send them. We'll send they're all in English this year, so that's a good thing. You know?
That's a bonus.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Thank you
Thanks
so much.
For having us.
Thanks, Ken. Appreciate it.
All right. So great start. LGB G-Scale, iconic brand in G-Scale. They just announced the new catalog. We're taking pre-orders now. We just posted most of the items. So keep on checking our website. And their catalog has come out if you haven't seen the new items. But a lot of good things. The new Christmas car. We'll be sending out an email probably within this week on their new product. So thank you so much, Gail and Stacy. And from one G-Scale company, we go to another, and we'll kick it off to John. How you doing, John?
Hello there, Ken and James. How are you?
Good.
All right. Well, I'm going to confuse things maybe by starting with some HO scale stuff, which Pico actually makes more products in HO than we do in G-Scale. There's almost 2,000 items in the other size of trains.
You're running up James's alley. That's it. I'm
excited. And up till now, all of that's been European prototype HO trains. But actually, some of the first American prototype models are going to be coming this year. And in front of me here, I don't know how well you can see that. I will try and zoom in a little bit for you on that. You want to see the trains rather than me anyway, so this is a big improvement for you, I'm sure. This is what we call a Siemens DeZero, and if you go to Germany, you can ride on this train. It's a diesel commuter rail car, and those are used for many suburban areas and even into big cities and lots of smaller cities. And several years ago, our own North County Transit District here in San Diego made the good decision to go with a very proven, reliable rail car for their new commuter service called the Sprinter. And Ken, do you have images of that available that you can put up? Oh, you are awesome. Yes. Okay. So this runs in the North County of San Diego and runs from the coastal city of Oceanside to the inland city of Escondido. And it connects with the Amtrak Surfliner, as well as Metrolink and the Coaster commuter services. So that could be a pretty busy scene at the station there at Oceanside when all those trains arrive together. So this is another part. Some of those, most of those have been modeled in HO scale by other brands. So now Pico is providing the Sprinter model to go along with those. and I guess, Christopher, yes, we make a lot of HO trains. Thank you. So I think the Sprinter is going to be attractive to a lot of folks, especially in Southern California, but also in, you know, around the country that just want a cool looking commuter train. You've got passenger service right here in one two-unit train. It will come in a non-sound version for normal two-rail American HO, and it will also come in two road numbers of sound versions. There you see the beautiful sunset views that you get in San Diego County. And it will also come in two road numbers of sound versions for the three-rail operators, and there are quite a few of those, especially that are familiar with the Pico brand, so I'm sure that a lot of folks will want the three rail versions as well. So I think it's a pretty cool train. We've been on that, and we were up at their headquarters at their maintenance facility. We got to do a lot of photography and for all the little details of the decorations. And we also did a lot of sound recording, so we can bring you the authentic sounds of the thing. Of course, there are some special things like station announcements that are unique to our route, not on the German ones. So I think people will enjoy that. And that's coming probably around August, September. And I'm sure Train World can hook people up with a great deal on it. So, Ken, do you also have photos of our other HO item? Not sure. Or is it just going to be me talking about it?
Oh, sorry, I was on mute. I'll bring that right up. But James, I want to hear your opinion on that, because that's a huge announcement, especially for you guys. Jonathan, I know you guys do a ton of business overseas for HO, but this is really taking a stab at the American market. What do you think, James?
Yeah, it's going to be pretty impressive. I know Walther's did some Surfliner cars. Jim Wigan may be able to correct me if Atherin did any motive power, but it's just a huge seller every time, because there's a contingent of modelers that model Southern California passenger train modelers. I think it's going to be a huge hit. I think it's going to be key to get that word out there that that's being made, because, you know, I've been in the hobby a long time and I wasn't even really aware that Pico made so much HO stuff. So I'll have to pay closer attention to that and kind of get that word out there also.
We'll send you an HO catalog, James. It's 452 pages.
Holy crap.
We'll make a few things, yeah.
All right. So, John, do you want to do the drum roll for your next announcement?
For the other HO item?
Yeah.
Sure. While you get it up there, I if you can put it on screen. Okay. This is another really unique model. We've gone, like many companies have done in recent years, and found it successful to do the niches in the market, do things that haven't been done before. And this is a Whitcomb from Whitcomb Locomotive Company, 65-ton diesel switcher. And this particular version that you're seeing here is the one that was made during World War II and was shipped over to Europe and was used in the European theater. And kind of really, there's a lot of history to them. These locomotives really helped win the war. And they often speak of World War II really being a war of the logistics of, you know, the side with the best supply and logistics is the side that ultimately won out. So they were there, you know, helping keep the rail lines moving, the supplies and moving people and materials. And many of them also stayed there after the war and helped in the rebuilding. And they were used by the U.S. Army Transportation Corps. So I know there are quite a few people that have already been all over chat rooms and have contacted us talking about these locos. So I know there's a lot of interest. It would be cool for a G-scale model too, maybe. but you know, lots of people had fathers or grandfathers that actually were in the U.S. Army Transportation Corps and ran these real locos in Europe. And yes, some of those locomotives, as World War II was wrapping up, many of them were shipped back to the States. There's a photo of one in the town of Cassino, Italy. And Cassino was almost leveled, unfortunately, but they stayed behind and had help with the rebuilding as well. Like the first train into Rome and the first train to cross the Rhine and the first train into Paris, but these little locos were there. So a lot of interesting history. And yes, they came back to America, many of them. Let's just say that not everything that has been announced so far is everything that will be announced this year. So I know there's a lot of people interested in versions that served on American short lines and didn't have the European buffers. So, of course, the tooling is very similar. So we planned for that. Let's just say that.
And John, actually, we had a good question from Peg. Will there be with yes, the American couplers, I guess.
That question right there. We can't tell you everything right now, but yes, the tooling is very similar, and we plan for that.
Okay, so gotcha.
We have to keep you guessing. Some surprises coming later as autumn new items, but yep, we're very, very on top of that.
Yeah, and for the HO people out there, we actually swapped out couplers with the KD couplers from European, if it's a European model, to the American style, if someone wants to run with American unit stuff. So it can be done.
Yes, and actually Pico makes a coupler that's designed, a knuckle coupler that's designed to go right onto this loco. I'm not 100% sure if the European style models will come with the American knuckle coupler, but it will be used, let's put it that way.
Very cool.
Okay. So if I can kind of, while you're finishing up there, let me move something aside here. And sorry. Okay. All right. I'm going to zoom out a little bit here. And back to G-Scale. Of course, I don't know, Ken, if you have any images of the G-Scale products, because yep. We do have the first four cars coming, right? There's one of them, Penzi Orcar. There's also a Rio Grande Orcar and a Union Pacific Hopper with the everybody loves the flag. So that's going to look great. And then also a Santa Fe boxcar. So those are coming. They're on the water. And as soon as the port of Los Angeles clears up a little bit, we'll get our container here sometime in February and have those here for you. And they will be on the shelves and flying off the shelves at Train World. But we're going to zoom out a little bit here. So, and these are, well, we'll show you here our switches. We call them by the R number, the radius number. This is R1, R5, and R7. And what's been missing here in the switches is R3. And this is 4 foot. R3 is 6 foot. R5 is 8 foot. And the R7 is 10 foot diameter. What's been missing for years in G-Scale from any brand is a switch in that size. So if we take a piece of our 280 millimeter straight track and our 140 millimeter straight track and put them together, that's the straight length of this switch. And if we put three pieces of the little fitter sections, the quarter sections of the R3 curve together, that's the shape of the curve. It will come with the little curve section as well to adapt into the normal standard 30 degree, 12 pieces per circle curve. And I think that's going to be just, it's something that people won't jump on at first, but as when they find it, they're going to say, wow, this is something I've been looking for a long time. And over time, it's going to be something that people just accept as a normal part, and it'll be as popular as all of our other switches. So I don't know what you guys' feelings are, but I think it fills a big gap in the G-Scale market.
That's great. Very cool.
And as far as other G-Scale items, we didn't bring anything here to show you, but you know, like I said, the first four items are coming as soon as we can get that container here. Also on that same container are the new G-Scale catalogs, 220 pages of G-Scale items, almost 700 items in the line, and those will be going out. So I'm sure your customers will want to get a copy on order with you guys. And also the new items flyers for those who don't have the full catalog. And we will also have about almost 70 new items, actually over 70 new items in G-Scale coming this year, and a whole bunch of surprises that we're working on. Again, autumn is going to bring some of our best and coolest new items. We're not going to just shoot the whole thing in January. There's going to be a lot more exciting new items coming in both G-Scale and HO.
That's great. And John, you guys, the big thing is tons of new product that you guys just announced, G-Scale and HO. And they're already asking where can they pre-order the Sprinter. So he's excited for it.
Train World, of course.
Yes, we're already taking pre-orders. I think Jonathan sent out the email to all the dealers, so everybody's getting up their pricing. We'll probably be sending out an email shortly on his G-Scale products and then to follow with the HO products, but totally new, different. And James, what do you think on this HO, both products now?
Oh, just amazing stuff. I look forward to seeing, you know, what all it entails. Sound, you know, it's all going to be different to me because I don't know if I've ever looked at any HO items from Pico. So I think you definitely need to send me the link to those Sprinters. I'll be probably pre-ordering those myself. And then I want to share that with my audience and make sure they know because
absolutely.
As much as my ear is to the ground of the hobby, stuff slips by me all the time.
That's true. There's so much today. You can miss some of it. Yeah.
That's great. So, well, tons of great product. I'm excited, John.
Glad to hear it. All right.
Well, thanks, John, for joining us. We appreciate it. Tons of great product. And we're going to start taking pre-orders now.
Cool. Yeah. They should be on their ordering right now.
Yes, we got to get the dial center going and do a hotline like they used to do in the old days. Very cool.
All right. Go ahead. Make Kenny's day. Put those orders in.
And then in turn, make John's day.
Absolutely.
All right, John. Thank you very much. And say hello to Renee out there.
I will.
I hope he's watching and he sees what a wonderful job you did.
Well, at the moment, it's midnight. He might not be watching, but.
All right. Well, I won't tell him you splurged on a new camera. So when he sees that invoice on the new camera, he'll know it was used today. All right, John. Thank you.
Take care.
All right. So great G-Scale and the HO product. So James should be happy now. But we're going to kick it over now to Bachmann Trains because they do a little bit of every scale. So we'll see what Larry has in store for us tonight. Then let me just get you going, Larry.
Hey, good evening, everybody. Hear me okay?
Coming in crystal clear.
Perfect. Yeah, I'm going to kick off the show tonight with the G-Scale product. I think it was on last night's show, somebody was asking about we make Thomas and G-Scale too. We'll get to that later. We do a whole Thomas section on this show tonight. So the G-Scale products that we've announced most recently are the retooled 460. I know somebody asked about that last night on your program. So they wanted to see the pictures. The majority of the tooling that we made improvements to was the tender and we may added some details and made the rivet size more prototypical, but the majority of the improvements are the inside of the locomotive. We've equipped it with a Pitman motor, a new gearbox, metal gears. It all also has a non-proprietary board that you can use to hook up either your sound systems or your battery systems or your DCC systems. Makes it real easy to convert the locomotive to however you want when you get it. So, I can show you some pictures here. I'm going to share my screen. Can we see my screen now? There we go. So this is the four road names we have in the 460. That's the Rio Grande Flying Grand. You see that okay, Jim? Making sure. The other paint scheme is the Bumblebee, which has always been a popular favorite. For your modelers who have their own railroads, we've always have a painted unlettered. We always do this in G scale and ON30 because they're the modelers in those scales like to make their own railroads more frequently than the other scales. And finally, the perennial Christmas favorite.
That'd be nice.
Yeah. So, that's been the most recent announcement. And then last year at NMRA, we made a huge announcement. It's actually on the cover of our catalog for this year. and give you a sneak peek of the catalog cover. We're not ready to release the catalog yet, but there's our Dash 9 that we'll be coming out with. We also have something that we, since we announced the locomotive, people made a number of suggestions that they wanted the locomotive in two road numbers. So we were able to convince our manufacturer to do that. And now each locomotive will come in two road numbers. So there's a little video of it in motion, and Ray Buteau, the Bachman's layout outside in his backyard. He filmed this for us before it was snowing.
So this is the actual prototype coming out?
This will be the prototype coming out. Yeah, the paint schemes, he's got the standard Norfolk Southern paint scheme on this particular model, but we will have the Operation Lifesaver on ours. So that'll be, you can see the road names we have here are CSX. Blow that up a little bit so you can see a little better. And we have BNSF, the most current paint scheme. And there's what I was talking about there, the Operation Lifesaver for the Norfolk Southern. And the Union Pacific, again, like Jonathan said, everybody likes a flag. We put the Building America flag on it. And the same as our cover shot there, the Santa Fe.
Cool.
So those are the major things we have in G-Scale. We have, you know, a good selection of everything. That really probably don't have time to talk about everything, but I'm sure you saw a lot of the Night Before Christmas sets for Under the Tree every year. And we also have the Eggliners do really well in large scale as well, too.
And the Dash 9, any estimated delivery time frame or?
We're still I haven't had a complete test shot model yet. So we're still fixing some molds. And once I get a prototype sample, I'll be happy to come back and show it to you on screen.
And Chris, we still don't have the pricing on the Dash 9s yet. So just hang tight and we'll start taking pre-orders a little later.
This is going to be a big seller from what I can tell from the number of dealers out there. I'm back on screen now. Everybody's told us that this locomotive is going to be pretty hot. Am I back on screen now,
No, you got to share it again.
No, I mean, am I on screen?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to go over some products now that I have in the other scales, and I'll show some videos after I'm finished doing that. Just to bring you up to speed on a lot of things, let's start out with the smallest scale. I have test shots for the GP38 with sound. This is the dynamic brake version. And we also are going to do that with a non-dynamic brake version. So the main difference is on the top there. And we also announced 100-ton Beth steel hoppers. Here's one sample of that. This is Pennsylvania Light and Power Company. That's my favorite one. So the actual sample will come with a coal load, but I don't have a coal load for this particular sample, but each one will come with a coal load. So they'll be shipping soon. This is one that was in our regular catalog that was just a paint scheme, but I thought it was really cool. Skolar. We also did this in HO, but the neat thing about it has yellow truck sides. So I thought that was pretty cool. And we had announced, you guys just got these in stock. How are they selling, the Hudsons?
Very well. Everybody loves New York from a New York company.
Yeah, they've been in stock for a couple weeks now, I think.
And yeah, doing very well.
Good. Glad to hear that. So these will be coming in shortly also. These are actual painted samples of the High Cube boxcar. We have two different types of door detail. If you see, the one's got the on the Burlington Northern is different than the Union Pacific. And then we also have Rio Grande and Santa Fe. So that's from most of my new announcements. But this one thing goes with all scales, so I'll talk to you about an N scale as well. This is coming out shortly. Last year, we came out with what we called a trackside decoder. This, that was made for HO. It was put inside of a scale building. It basically, you know, you convert your standard analog turnouts to DCC. So if you've already got your layout built and you're just like, I want to convert to DCC now, but how do I do it? Well, we sell DCC switches, but we also have, you know, if you've already put all your track down, it's kind of a pain to take them up and put new ones in. So we've come out with this as well. This is called a trackside decoder. This is exactly the same as the control box that comes with our standard analog turnouts on the outside, but on the inside, it's a actual DCC decoder. So you program this by pressing the button and following the instructions. And once you've done that, you just you have a DCC controlled turnout on your layout. Works for all scales. It'll work for HO, N scale, even two rail O if you have that, or ON30. So it's an easy way to upgrade. It's a bridge product to get you to the next level. A lot of people start with analog trains and then they go to the, you know, the DCC with sound and all the fancy functions with, and it brings out the, brings your train to life once you get the DCC. So that's an HO. I'm going next is everybody wants to hear about the chargers. Yeah, we have chargers. We have some, we have none. I think Train World still has some, but I think everybody else in the country is out of them. we sold so quickly. I've never had that happen before in my entire career. We sold out before they even came into our warehouse. And I'm sure they're selling well for you, but I see you still have them in stock. So if you haven't got your charger yet, come to Train World because that's where to get them.
Yeah, the first few numbers, I only got a couple of pieces left, but the amount that we purchased was ridiculous. So this was a very, very hot engine this year, and it's really cool. I mean, we did a special segment on it, and a lot of people were floored away. And James, I think you could attest to how cool that is.
Well, I got a video coming up a little bit later. I'll show you some of the major features in a couple minute video so that, you know, if your viewers didn't see it when we did that special a couple weeks ago, it'll highlight the features. Another item in HO that we announced was the Streamline Caboose. Now, this is something we've had in our product line for a while, but we freshened up the tooling. We put new glass glazing in there and gave it some really nice paint schemes. This is one of my favorites, the Norfolk Western. It's got the safety stripes on both ends. Pretty striking paint scheme. We got it in three other paint schemes in the box. Here we got Grand Trunk, and we have Burlington, and also Wabash. This one's pretty good looking too. So they're in stock now. You should have them, Ken. I hope they're selling well for you as well. These will be coming in soon. These are our 52-foot converted beam cars. So they're what a lot of the railroads did. You've seen bigger cars that carry lumber, but they took some of their extra 52-foot cars and put bulkheads on them and center beams so that they could stack the lumber and balance it without falling over. We got that in four road names. This will be in stock, I believe, in about a month, maybe a month and a half. That's one of the other. This is British. And this is Northern Pacific. And finally, Canadian National. It's got like three colors on it. That's pretty good looking. So one of our new, also retooling is our 060 locomotive. I got one of the test shots here. The tender, we're gonna have a couple different versions of the tender. This one is the one with the extended bunker. We also have a low version for the tender and an oil burner for the Union Pacific version. Here's our HOK4, one of our paint samples for that. This is the early version slat pilot, as you can see on the screen there. We also have the modern version. It's kind of in four road numbers. This will have the same sound system as our Streamline K4 head, and it will be the WOW Sound version of the decoder. And what we did on this was make sure that we didn't repeat any of the road numbers we've done in the past. We've done the K4 many times, and just wanted to make sure that if you have it already, you could add to your fleet. So real exciting addition besides to our track line is our Easy Track girder bridges. We got that in 4 versions. One thing about it, bridges before, we didn't have any way to, we made them with the connector, so they just snap in place.
Cool.
These should be in stock too. Ken, how are these selling for you?
Very good. Beautiful.
Pennsylvania Railroad. We have Union Pacific and
nice ass.
Santa Fe. This one's in the package still. This is how you see it on the shelf. So kind of have to look at it sideways to see which one it is. But that's for HO. And we'll go over a couple things real quick for Williams. We did get the egg liner prototype in.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
Yep. So with unpainted version, but this is going to come in 4 different versions. It'll be in Christmas, Halloween, Easter, and 4th of July or Independence Day. Yeah.
Very cool.
Couple of the previously announced Easy Street cars. This one's pretty nice looking. It's a sheriff car. Always have to have the Easy Street on with the trains. It really brings your layout to life with the cars moving around as well. It's a black sedan. And here's a red sedan. So bring some fire to the layout there. So that's a quick recap of the things that we just got in or are coming in shortly. What I'm going to do is share a couple videos with you first. Normally we go over new products on this, but we do have some new starter sets. Our Midwest sales rep, David Melville, is going to show you some of our new sets. And then I'll put in a charger video to show you the details for that. And then finally, we'll follow up with Doug Blaine, our vice president of marketing, and he will give you an overview of Thomas and Friends. So let me share the screen one more time.
Hi, my name is Dave Melville with Bachmann Industries. It's my pleasure today to talk to you about Bachmann starter sets. Bachmann is the world's largest and most complete manufacturer of model train starter sets. In fact, we manufacture over 40 different starter sets in several different scale sizes with a variety of different features. Today, I'd like to talk to you about a couple of new products. The very first one is the Yardmaster. The Yardmaster is an entry-level starter set featuring this really cool-looking gray 060 locomotive, has Bachmann Easy Track, Power Pack, and Speed Controller in with each set. The really cool feature about this starter set is that the locomotive itself has an operating headlight and a factory installed operating smoke unit. Simply take a few drops of smoke fluid, put it in the stack, and as that train's running around the track, that locomotive is going to puff and smoke. A really cool feature for an entry level starter set. Also new for us are 2 new starter sets in N scale, and these are DCC or digital command control sets, and the sets come with locomotives with prototypical sounds. So these are sound locomotives. In the case of the Roaring Rails, it's a diesel locomotive with prototypical diesel sounds. In the case of the Whistle Stop, it's a steam style locomotive with prototypical steam sounds. Each set comes with the Bachmann nickel silver N-scale Easy Track in the set, and a Bachmann Easy Command Controller. The Easy Command Controller is designed to allow you to run DCC locomotives and control the speed, direction, lighting, and in this case, the sound of each set. One of my colleagues is going to now take you to a video clip so you can see the prototypical sound. Thank you for shopping Bachmann Trains at Train World.
Attention, please. Now departing on track one, northbound train number 110. Passengers are advised to proceed to track one at this time. All aboard.
Welcome. I'm Doug Blaine from Bachmann Trains, Vice President of Marketing, and I'm happy to share an update with you on our Thomas & Friends product in three different scales. I'm going to start with what was new in 2020 and talk about some updates on progress for products you haven't seen yet, and we'll go from there. So I'm going to start with one of our new, this is N-scale train set, complete ready to run train set, train track, power pack, everything you need to get going. And this comes with a 24-inch circle of track, Thomas, Annie, and Clarabelle. So one thing about this set that you might want to know is that it comes with a 75th anniversary sticker, which is right down here. And that was to celebrate the 75th anniversary of Thomas and Friends in 2020. As we move forward through 2021, we will sell out of this set and the sticker will not appear anymore after that. The sticker is on the outside of the cellophane, but if you wanna have a sticker set, be sure to get one soon because we will sell out of these sets and they will be out of the marketplace, I think rather quickly. So that's the start to our N-Scale collection. And I also wanted to run through some of the N-Scale separate sale products that we have. Some of these are duplicate from what was in the set. And I'm going to start with the separate sale, Thomas, Annie, and Clarabelle. It's just good to see everything together. So these three are currently on the market, and I'm going to set them up on the table as we add some other pieces to the collection here as well. So there's Thomas, Annie, and Clarabelle. Next will be Percy and the Troublesome Trucks. They are currently in the market as well. So we'll get those out. And again, it's just nice to see everything together as a collection. There's Percy, Troublesome Truck number one, and Troublesome Truck number two. And additionally, for 2020, we had three tank cars. This was an oil tank, a fuel tank, and a water tank. So those, again, are available. And everything together is colorful and is a great way to start an N-Scale collection. I also wanted to update you on James, which was also announced in 2020. James is coming on along nicely. We've already seen our first test shot for James, so he will be available later in 2021. That's the start of our N-Scale line in Thomas, and we will move on to HO. Similar to our N-Scale sets, we also have two new HO sets with the 75th anniversary logo and sticker on the outside of the shrink wrap. So these are terrific starter sets. This one is Thomas with Annie and Clarabelle. As an added feature of our HO scale locomotives, the eyes on Thomas move back and forth. So the eyes scan back and forth as it travels down the track. It's a great animation, fun to watch, and a feature that is included on all of our HO scale locomotives. So again, complete ready to run, train, track, and power pack. This comes with a circle of SnapFit Easy Track. And I'm going to show you another set we have. This is a deluxe set. And this comes with Thomas and the Troublesome Trucks that have ore loads. What's great about this set is that it has some unique features that is not available anywhere else except in this set. So specifically, there is a quarry tower and the Troublesome Trucks with unique ore loads. The only place you can get those, again, is the set, and I will show you those next. This is the quarry tower, which comes with a nice Sodor logo on it, and the quarry cars are the Troublesome versions, Troublesome Truck number one and Troublesome Truck number two, with the specific ore load for this set. So only available in the deluxe Thomas with the quarry cars, and I hope you will find the set to enjoy these special features. I also wanted to share two new versions of our James locomotive in HO scale. We of course have the original Red James, and in 2020 we introduced Busy Bee James in a really striking black and yellow paint scheme. That is currently on the market. We also introduced in 2020 a Origin James. This was James before he was painted in his bright, shiny red paintwork. James arrived on the island of Sodor in the black paint scheme, and it's just a great variation to see to have on your layout for three different versions of James: Origin James in black, the Busy Bee James in yellow and black, and of course, the familiar shiny red paintwork. Also, we have another Origin locomotive in HO scale, and that is Thomas. We have Thomas in his original paint scheme before he came to the island of Sodor. This is Thomas LBSC 70, that's London and Brighton South Coast. And this is how Thomas came to the island of Sodor before he was painted in his familiar blue. So for your Thomas collection, an original blue and the LBSC 70, is a great addition as well. I also wanted to share some separate sale wagons in HO scale. We have 3 1-plank wagons. This one is a 1-plank wagon with a crate, Brendan Bay Shipping Company. Another version with a different crate is the Brendan Cargo and Freight Company. And then we have a third, which is the Sodor Steamworks. So this is just great options for variety and making up your consist on your railroad and add some different colors. And the crates are a new addition for your island of Sodor as well. And lastly, in HO scale, we have a new piece of rolling stock. This was not shipped in 2020. The 1-plank wagons were shipped in 2020. This is a new tank wagon that will be shipped in 2021. This is an African tanker, troublesome truck number 6. So that will be heading your way this year. And now for a big finish for our product review for new products in 2020 and 2021. I have our large scale diesel. We showed you an earlier version of this in some previous videos and online, but now we have a painted version that is almost ready for prime time. I'm not exactly sure what the delivery date will be in 2021, but it will be out this year. So this, like our HO scale models, also has moving eyes that scan back and forth as it travels down the track. And it's a nice, chunky, heavy duty, large scale, grumpy diesel locomotive. Coming your way, it can join our other large scale locomotives in the Thomas line. We have Thomas, Percy, Emily, James, and also Toby. And we have a Winston car that doesn't have any moving eyes, but also joins the other pieces of motive power in large scale Thomas. Thank you for joining us for our product review for 2020 and 2021 products. Hope you enjoyed seeing them. We enjoyed sharing them and look forward to a new video coming out soon with our new product introductions in 2021. Be on the lookout. Thank you so much.
All right.
Okay. Hope that wasn't too much information for everybody, but we have a lot of scales, so yeah. A lot of products to go through.
Lots to cover and a lot of good stuff. And I see all the Thomas fanatics all excited about that. So
yeah, I was watching the comments on my phone while we were doing it. It's pretty amazing.
Very cool.
So very nice. So
did you ever get into Thomas when you were young?
I did not. I was into the 2-3-rail trains. My grandfather used to take me down to the train yards in Baltimore, and we look at the ships as well in the shipyards, and did a Christmas layout every year. And then probably when I was about 11, the bug bit me and I was doing it full time then. So
how about you, James?
Yeah, I watched the show when I was little. I didn't have a set, but man, it's a great ambassador to the hobby looking at it from the adult aspect.
Very cool. So a lot of great products, and we're excited to see what else is in tune. Then you guys are actually going to be launching a new catalog, hopefully in the next month or so. So be on the lookout. And
Yep.
Sounds good. But a lot of good stuff. Thank you so much, Larry. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right. And we'll continue the mix. We'll kick it over to Jim from Athern. And let me get you going. Hold on 1 second, Jim. Get you situated. How you doing, Jim?
I'm doing great, Ken. How about yourself?
All right. Now you got to introduce yourself to everyone because it feels like a longer time, but you're a newer face to Athern.
Yeah, that's right. I came on board this past August of 2020. So, one of the new guys here at Athern.
Very cool. So Athern, long standing company, known for their HO, N-scale trains. What do you guys have in store for us?
Man, it's a special year for us, Ken, because we're going on 75 years since 1946. We've been giving modelers all kinds of cool stuff. And I got a little bit of everything here for you today. I got some HO, got some N-scale. Let me show you what your customers are going to want to get in touch with you before Friday, because we've got some exciting pre-orders to go over. So let me go ahead and share my screen here. And I'll bring up our first item. All right. Everybody see that okay?
Yep.
All right. Awesome. So what we've got here is the SD70M-2 diesel locomotive. Now, we have offered this in the past. It's been a while, though. It's 2014 was about the last time we had these. And this time, we're pleased to introduce them with the Genesis 2.0. So what does that mean? You get all the great features of Genesis that you're used to, but you're also going to get see-through pilot steps. On the Canadian National versions, you're going to get lit marker lights that actually function. You're going to get the lit number boards, and what's really cool is the ground lights. Now, the ground lights and the number boards, they're not super bright. They are pretty prototypical. They're just a nice dim light. So if you're doing some operation stuff in low light situations, it really brings out the realism of these locomotives. Not only that, but we've got some great roads that we're sharing this time. And we've got some, you know, first up here, we've got Norfolk Southern, you know, beautiful, beautiful railroad, beautiful paint scheme, really sharp, all business on this paint scheme here. We're offering that in three road numbers, and it's available without sound or with sound. And of course, that does come with the Tsunami 2 Soundtracks decoder. Coming up next, we've got the Florida East Coast. Now, what's really cool about this paint scheme, Ken, is this paint scheme did not last long. They got these locomotives, they painted them up in the Rail America-inspired paint scheme, and really didn't last long. So if you're looking for something that kind of unique, you know, a little bit different, this is definitely a paint scheme you're going to want to pick up. And this would be appropriate, you know, if you've got a layout that's about 2008 on forward, you can definitely justify getting this this workhorse for your layout. We've got this available in three road numbers as well. Now, I know my fellow I'm an East Coast guy myself, and Ken, I know you guys, some of your customers out there on the east side of the United States are going to love these. This is the Vermont Railway set. And when I say set, they have two of these. So your customers can get the complete set of SD70M-2s in the Vermont Railway system. Striking red scheme, beautiful locomotive. You can see that prototype picture down there we got from Steve, and man, you know, this is kind of cool. I mean, New Englander myself, it's kind of cool to see these big modern day locomotives rumble through the Green Mountain State. Now, keeping up with that trend, we didn't want to forget about these guys either. And I'm gonna have to break out into my East Coast for you guys. This is the Providence and Worcester. SD70M-2. So for all my fellow friends out there in the Massachusetts area, yeah, it is Worcester. Don't listen to my work associates and think it's Worcester. It's not.
Perfect timing for the Big E train show too.
Exactly. Yeah, this is the perfect timing. And you know, and of course we all know, you know, the PNW now, it's part of the you know, it's been covered in that orange color that you know, short line. So this orange and brown paint scheme, again, it didn't last long, but when they were applied to the SD70M-2s, they were hot. I mean, it's just a really cool paint scheme. We all know that the modelers of the PNW are really passionate about their railroad, as they should be. And so we wanted to offer the SD70M-2 for those guys as well. So there you go. You got two down there. Now, what's really cool is we wanted to do some Canadian National. I mean, Canadian National, they're not only in Canada, but even here where I'm living in central Illinois, you know, when they bought the IC, we see these guys all over the place. This is their most current paint scheme. But they're doing something really, really cool. Like a lot of other Class 1 railroads, they're starting to do some heritage stuff. And you can kind of see on the nose of this one here, we've got some heritage markings. But we didn't stop there. We did something a little bit interesting. We did this 8934. Kind of looks like a weird paint scheme. Really isn't. I mean, anybody that knows these battery doors and compartment doors, they're pretty much all the same. And, you know, they go into maintenance, and when they swap out parts and stuff like that, they just, the doors fit, they put them on there. So this is what happened here. Somebody put the doors out of sequence. We found this one of our guys at Athern out on the West Coast got a picture of 8934, and we thought, hey, you know what? Modelers like this kind of stuff, so let's go ahead and do that. But there again, we didn't stop again. We're really excited about the Heritage unit for the Grand Trunk. You know, Canadian National just pulled this out late fall of 2020, and it's taken the railfan community by storm. And so we're pleased to offer this locomotive in the Heritage paint scheme for the Grand Trunk. And I mean, that's a cool paint scheme. It's kind of cool to see that throwback paint scheme from, you know, the 1970s into the 1980s, see a modern day locomotive like that painted up like that. So, you know, you're going to want to call Trainland and get your orders in on these, because I do not think these 70M-2s are going to last too long.
They're really cool paint schemes.
Yeah, they really are. And I mean, there was a lot of work went into, especially the Grand Trunk one. We literally had some help from our fans that got some boots on the ground photography, and we were able to get this offered up really quickly. So really looking forward to this Heritage unit. Of course, all those other ones just in time for the Amherst show. Next one I want to talk about. All right, Ken, can you see that okay?
I think we lost your share screen.
All right, let me go back here real quick. And here we go. All right, so this is the Genesis Series HO. And by the way, we're also, for the N-Scale guys out there, we're offering the same model and the same roads in N-Scale, and not only with the decoder, but with the Tsunami 2 onboard sound equipped decoder. So now the N-Scale guys can have some fun too with the sound. We're offering this with the Milwaukee road paint scheme, as you see here, offered in two different road numbers. Of course, you can't go wrong with the Santa Fe War Bonnet. We're offering that in the late 60s and early 1970s paint scheme. And then this is pretty cool. I mean, we all remember, I'm hoping a lot of us remember, the failed merger between the Southern Pacific and the Santa Fe. Some of these got painted up in that cool Kodachrome paint scheme. And that's what we're doing here. We're going to do the mid-1980s failed Kodachrome paint scheme. We're offering those in three different road numbers. And, of course, these are all Santa Fe based. And then we wanted to do more. We wanted to offer the modelers more. There's a lot of modelers out there that like to model, you know, what would have happened if the Southern Pacific and Santa Fe had merged. Well, Athern's willing to answer those questions and more. We're coming out with our new legendary liveries. These are iconic paint schemes that are applied to locomotives that never really wore them. So, you know, the FP45, of course, did exist. The Kodachrome paint scheme, of course, exists, but not quite like this. So think of it as like this, an alternate timeline. What if the Southern Pacific and the Santa Fe had merged? This is what it would have looked like. Likewise, looking at our Burlington Northern Santa Fe, BNSF, you know, in the late 90s into the early 2000s, they were power hungry. They needed locomotives, and they really were using FP45s right up until around 2002 or so. And if you remember, around 2002, they came out with the Heritage 2 paint scheme. So it's not too much of a stretch to think about seeing one of these FP45s in the Heritage 2 paint scheme. So with a stroke of a pen, this could have happened. It's part of our legendary liveries. And then we figured, you know what? Let's throw a Western Pacific in there as well. I mean, it's a really cool, iconic paint scheme. And it kind of answers the question, you know, if Western Pacific was ready to upgrade their passenger fleet and Amtrak never happened, this is probably what Western Pacific passenger stuff would have looked like at that time. So these are all based on a lot of research, believe it or not, of things that could have happened if history had gone that route. Now, once again, everything you see here, these are examples from our Genesis line. You can get those with or without sound. And we're also offering those in N-Scale as well. Some pretty cool locomotives that we're coming out with there. We're also doing the freight version. Let me bring that up for you real quick.
Very cool. Nice stuff.
It's a dangerous job, Ken. You know, I have to hide this stuff from my wife because we just keep coming out with so much cool stuff. All right, here we go. HO scale, Genesis, F45 locomotives. Now, again, we're offering these in the Genesis HO line as well as N scale. N scale are available with or without sound. These are the freight versions of the FP45s, and we're happy to offer these in two different versions. The first one we got up here is the Burlington Northern, and what these are, these represent the early era of the Burlington Northern. These were technically locomotives that were on order for the Great Northern. So they're going to have all the details that a Great Northern locomotive would have had from the factory. But, you know, while those were being built, the Burlington Northern was formed. And so in the middle of that order, they basically got painted into the then new corporate paint scheme of Cascade green and black. And so that's what we've got here. We've got this offered in three different road numbers. And again, that represents early Burlington Northern. So you're talking early 1970s. And then last but certainly not least, Wisconsin Central. Really cool paint scheme, really cool railroad. We know there's some hardcore Wisconsin Central fans out there. We wanted to help them out in both HO and N scale. And these are based on Santa Fe units that were retired around 1995 into the early 2000s. And so they have Santa Fe style details, but they've got the Wisconsin Central paint scheme, really, really classy paint scheme. And then last but not least, we can't finish without showing you these. These are pretty cool. You're going to want these on the end of your Santa Fe trains. We are coming out with the Genesis HO scale ICC caboose for Santa Fe. Now, we're doing this in a nice range of paint schemes for different eras. You can see there at the top, we've got pretty much the as-delivered ICC caboose. These are appropriate for 1974 up to 1980 or so. And then you can see in the mid-1980s, they changed things a little bit. The font's different. The logo's a little bit bigger. All of your detail has changed a little bit. You no longer have that black underframe. So if you're doing the 1980s, right up until about the end of the caboose era, the second one is perfect for you. One you're going to want to get in on quickly. This is a scheme that we've not offered on our Genesis series cabooses. This is the Kodachrome version, Santa Fe. It's based on some pictures that we found. Guys out on the West Coast found some really cool pictures of this caboose. Was it actually used in service? We can't prove that, but we can prove that this locomotive did exist, or I'm sorry, this caboose did exist in this paint scheme. And once again, it's not been offered on a Genesis before. So if you like the Kodachrome and you want to, you know, finish up that Kodachrome theme, this is the caboose for you. And once again,
those cabooses are huge sellers. I mean, everybody goes crazy for them. And I think all the dealers and probably you guys were nervous on the price point because, you know, it's an expensive caboose, but the detail and, you know, the demand, people went crazy for these. I mean, it's just a beautiful caboose, brand new tooling. So you guys did a really great job and people seem to be gobbling them up.
Yeah, thank you, Ken. I mean, it's one of those things where, you know, in the past, in order to get a caboose to this level of detail, there was plenty of detail parts out there. and paint and decals and all that. There was plenty of that out there. And it's certainly there's, we know modelers have the ability to do that. But, you know, the good thing about this is you can just take this caboose out of the package, put it on your railroad, and that leaves you more time to build some amazing layouts. And so we're trying to like keep it a little bit easier so you guys can actually get out there and work on your layout, you know, do the fun stuff, not have to worry about all those different details. I mean, because Atherin, we've done the research for you. You know, last but not least, we've got the SPSF, another one that, you know, there's proof. We've got pictures. And it's like I say, pictures are it never happened. We actually found pictures of this caboose painted up in this paint scheme. But, of course, that merger did not go through. But there is proof that this one here was done in the prototype. So if you want something different to run on the club layout or your own layout, you're going to want to pick this guy up. And then Toledo, Peoria, and Western. That's kind of a local one for us here, Ken. It's a small railroad here in central Illinois. And they were owned by the Santa Fe back in the 1980s. So it was only natural to use Santa Fe equipment. As you can see here, they're using the Santa Fe caboose that's been lettered for the TP&W. And so that's going to be popular with guys that either do the Santa Fe or have connections with the TP&W.
Great.
So, yeah, those are some of the things that we've got going on right now at Atherin. And like I said, all of those are open for pre-order. In fact, you can go through Train World till Friday the 29th. So if you haven't made your order on any of those or anything else that we've offered in the January announcements, you're going to want to get in touch with Train World and put your order in. Ken, I know you guys are busy. I've got some stuff here to show the audience of what you guys have in stock now.
Cool.
Let's see. First thing I got. I know you guys, you probably had these for a couple of weeks now, but these are the GP7Us. This is the former Bangor and Aroostook unit. This is one of the prime for grime units. And I think Ken, you've probably had these in for a couple of weeks now, right?
Very cool paint scheme. Unique.
Yeah, very much so. Very cool paint scheme. You know, if you're an HO scale modeler and you're into the more of the switching type layout or the industrial switcher, these are perfect for that. These are the based on the Santa Fe Topeka shops Jeep sevens. They've chopped the nose. They've given it a Topeka cab. Really nice detail. These are Genesis, and they're available with or without sound. And, you know, but the camera doesn't do it justice, but that gives you an idea of how nice this is. The Prime for Grime, you can see how they've kind of re-lettered it a little bit. See if I can put this other side here for you.
Very cool.
This one's kind of left so that you can really go to town and do some weathering on it. So definitely, if you've got a nice switching module in your club, or if you've got a switching area on your layout, we're offering those in many different roads. Likewise, and Ken, I think these just came into stock for you guys maybe about a week ago. If you're looking for some class one road power, the SD75Ms and the Genesis series have just come in stock. And of course, we got this BNSF version in a not your standard paint scheme. Yeah. We try to find some, you know, we do the standard class one paint schemes, but we also try to get as much research to find interesting paint schemes like this. It's kind of like a variation of the Heritage one with a swoosh. But beautiful six axle SD75M. These are in stock now. So if you need some mainline power, definitely give the guys at Train World a call and order one of these today. They are in stock.
Very cool. All right, nice stuff.
No, thank you, Ken.
Yeah, the Atherin stuff always sells well. Genesis is the top of the line stuff, really good quality. And those cabooses, I mean, tremendous orders on the cabooses. I was actually placing an order with you guys the other week, actually this week, and your DD40 is actually one of the numbers. We actually just bought up the rest because the numbers were so crazy. It was just insane. And you guys did DD40s before, but you know, for some reason, people want them. I mean, it's unbelievable the amount of orders. It's crazy.
You see what's behind me, Ken, is some Boston made GP40-2. So if I'm reading you right, I'm gonna have to call you next week when those come in.
Yep. So a lot of good stuff, and always making it entertaining. And thank you very much, Jim, for coming on. And we're always looking forward to see you, meet you, and do more.
You bet. Thanks, Ken. Thanks for the opportunity.
All right. Thanks, Jim. Appreciate it. All right. And now we're going to kick it over to Ryan. Where are you? There you are, Ryan. You were hiding on me.
Yeah.
I couldn't see you. You were hiding from your beard.
Yeah, I'm hiding behind my whiskers.
All right. Ryan needs no introduction. Lion-L Trains. And Lion-L, they make a ton of different product. And what do you got for us tonight, Ryan? Because you've been busy. You got a new catalog, too.
We've been very busy at the office the last couple of months, Ken. And, yeah, we have two new catalogs that came out just a few days ago. Of course, our O-Scale catalog and also our American Flyer catalog, sort of two in one combined in the book. So I've got a couple of things here to show and talk about, and I'm not going to go into a ton of detail tonight because I get to come back here next week and go into all those catalogs in a little bit more detail.
That's right.
But let's share here. And hopefully you're seeing everything okay.
We got it.
All right. So before I get into the catalog itself, we've got two really cool new features coming out. One will be delivering a little bit later this year in some of our ready-to-run sets for the first time, and the other one is available right now. So coming later this year will be our voice streaming and recording feature. And this will allow you in the Lion Chief app, which is a free downloadable app you can get on your Apple or your Android device that controls all of our Bluetooth trains. This will now allow you to go in and record or play live stream your own sounds and then have them play through the locomotive. So it'll be a really neat feature if you want to create your own crew talk or use other sound files and put them in the engine. You can do all that with a press of a button, or even press the button and speak live and do your own live conductor announcements and train announcements and so forth. It'll be a really fun feature and add another dimension to our sets. And then available right now on the app is our LVC, our Lion-L Voice Control. And this allows you to do just what the name implies. You can control the train's actions with your own voice commands. So you'll go into the app and there's a little icon that you'll press to activate the voice command prompt. It'll tell you to give a command and then it'll register that and apply the action. So this works in all of our Bluetooth equipped engines. It's live right now. So if you already have the app, you can just update the app in your device and this feature will come up. If you haven't gotten it yet, go into your app store and type in Lion-L, Lion Chief, and this will pop up and download it. This works on anything with Bluetooth that we've made since about 2017 through today. So if you've got anything we've made in that time frame, whether it's our HO trains, a Flyer Chief, Lion Chief, Lion Chief Plus, Lion Chief 2.0, even the new legacy products that have Bluetooth on board, you'll be able to control your trains and use this function, which is really neat. And you can do a lot of different functions with this, everything from, you know, changing direction and setting speed, to also, you know, asking it to ring the bell or blow the whistle. There's even some little buried things in there, like you can tell it to blow for the railroad crossing, and it'll blow two longs, a short, and a long for the crossing coming up. So another neat way to control your train, virtually hands-free. It's part of a long tradition of Lion-L trying to reach out and come up with new and innovative ways to interact with our trains and our hobby. And we think this one's going to be a lot of fun. And like I said, it's available right now. So there's nothing holding you back from downloading it and giving it a try. It is actually a lot of fun.
Yeah, Ryan, this is actually groundbreaking stuff. I mean, no, I don't think anyone else in the industry has done this yet. This is pretty, really wild stuff. And it gets the families, kids, and even adults involved. And Howard actually mentioned like a pre-introduction to this on the Train World Ball, but I'm glad you guys are pushing through with this. So we're really pumped up for this, and it's going to be awesome on starter sets. I mean, that's wild.
Yeah, we're really excited about this one too. A lot of work has gone into this over the last over a year's worth of development in this by our engineering team, and it's kind of a game changer in the way you can interact with your trains and have some fun. And you know, what's better is it's available now and it's free. So that's a pretty nice bonus in there. And I hope people will go out and give it a try. It's not going to completely replace your DCC systems or your legacy command control systems and everything that those will do, but definitely I think you're starting to see the next generation of model railroad control coming down the line here in these features.
How much does it cost, Ryan?
It's free.
Free? Really? Wow.
I know. That is crazy, right?
Download.
So, yep, it's a free download, and you're good to go. Of course, you got to buy the train, but other than that, you're free. You're good to go.
Very cool. That's awesome. That's a great feature.
All right. So with that, let's talk about some of the new catalogs. We've got two new catalogs just came out, over 200 pages of new product here. Everything from high-end steam and diesel to new ready-to-run sets to American Flyer, celebrating 75 years of S-gauge American Flyer trains this year also. So another big anniversary year. Of course, Lionel just turned 120 last year. So we're getting up there in years, but still trying to be very innovative. And I think you'll see some really neat things where I'm just going to highlight a couple of my favorites from the catalog tonight. As I said, we'll get into this, I'm sure, in much more detail next week when you and I are together for a long time and can turn all the pages. First up, the creme de la creme for Lionel is our Vision line. And these represent new innovative features, the most that we can do in a scale locomotive. Lots of innovation goes into these and makes for a really amazing top-of-the-line product. And for this catalog, we are re-releasing one of the first Vision line models that we did back about 2010. And we took what was an innovative and groundbreaking model then and made it even a little bit better for this go-around. So this is the Santa Fe 21010-2. A real odd duck of a locomotive. The Santa Fe had about 10 of these that they cobbled together from pairs of 2102 steam locomotives. And they weren't a very successful kit bash on the prototype. They couldn't generate enough steam to do very well. So they lasted a couple of years and then got split back apart into two locomotives again. But we wanted to do this locomotive over because since it's been done the last time, of course, our legacy systems and other features have gotten a lot more rich and developed. So this locomotive is packed with things from front to back. You've got three smoke units in here. So you have chuffing smoke from the stack. You've got whistle steam. When you blow the whistle, you get the plume of steam from the whistle. And you have blowdown steam as well on these that simulates the boiler blowdown effect back near the firebox. These also have the really popular swinging bell feature. So when you ring the bell on the top of the locomotive actually swings back and forth in time with the dings, which is a small detail, but amazing how quickly that draws your eye in when you see that on a model train and gets a lot of people who aren't familiar with the hobby. They see something like that and it really makes them scratch their head and dive into the model even more. We've upgraded it this time around with a three-speaker sound system, which will be sort of the stereo sound you've come to expect from our Vision steam and our larger steam locomotives. So you've got speakers in both the tender and the boiler. Some of the sounds are in stereo, like your chuffing. Others are more localized, so they sound like they're coming from the right spot in the locomotive. And now, of course, for the first time, this will have Bluetooth control. It'll have our latest upgrades to Legacy, which include five selectable whistles, as well as they all still quill, so you can vary the pitch of those whistles as you're playing them. You'll have the bicolor marker light or class light, so you can change from white to green or off on the lighting. And as I said, Bluetooth and now voice control on these as well. So a lot packed into what looks like a very big, but actually is kind of a small steam engine, at least in terms of boilers. So it's a challenge to pack all that in there. But our engineers and our production teams have done a great job of squeezing it all in somehow.
And those are gorgeous. Really, Really nice engines.
Yeah, we'll have four paint schemes available on this. Two will be the prototypical Santa Fe, relatively plain paint schemes like the 3009 you see up there. One with polished rods and one with darkened rods. And then we're doing two fantasy paint schemes, sort of our versions of the what ifs. One that you see here is the Black Bonnet, which started off on some F3 diesels many, many decades ago in the catalog and has developed a bit of a cult following in the O-gauge world. And this will have a glossier paint finish with the red and yellow trim on the tender. And then we're also doing a paint scheme based on the Valley Flyer with the silver and yellow and red striping on that as well. A really beautiful locomotive. And you know, Ken, those fantasy paint schemes, they've really done a lot for us in terms of sales. People love to jump on those and add them to their collections.
Yeah, I mean, it's something new, different, and colorful. People love color.
So from old steam locomotives to Acelas. This catalog really does run the gamut. We've got everything from the John Bull to Acelas in this catalog. We really covered the span of railroad history on this one. We're bringing back the Acela this year. It's been well over a decade since this was last run by Lionel. We're doing it in the prototypical Amtrak scheme as they're getting ready to phase these out. We wanted to do one more run of these. We've also got a number of proposed or what-if paint schemes, some heritage-style paint on these. And also the first prototype or proposed paint scheme for the train, what was going to be called, of all things, the American Flyer. So we thought that was pretty cool and did an homage to that in the catalog as well. We're changing some of the features out on this. The first time these were done decades ago, it was very much an innovative and action-packed model, filled with all sorts of gadgets and engineering. And great train when you could get it on the track and get it all to run and stay working reliably. But often a pain in the butt to get that to happen. So we took some of the things out that were a little bit too complicated and too costly and made some simplifications, but only in things that wouldn't really diminish the overall value of the set or the fun value of this train. So for the new versions, some things have also been upgraded. Now, both locomotives are powered and both locomotives will have sound. As well as the operating pantographs. We've completely redesigned the trucks on these, so you'll actually be able to take and change a traction tire without disassembling the entire model. We thought that would be kind of a neat feature. And then the passenger cars also, these will still tilt. It's now a mechanical design instead of one that was driven by a couple of electrical sensors and a motor. So a little bit more of a simplified design there, but you'll still have the cars lean into the curve as you go around at high speed. And the core set will come with two powered units and then three passenger cars in the middle. And if you want to do a full six-car Acela, there's a three-car add-on pack that also includes a station sound club car. And we'll be doing special sounds, of course, for these trains with all of the announcements and special calls and so forth. A really neat, neat train set. And anybody who's been on the Northeast Corridor for the last 20 years knows these well and we'll enjoy them and want to have them on their railroad, I'm sure. Turning to our ready-to-run train sets, as with Bachmann, this is a huge portion of our business is our ready-to-run starter sets and introducing new people into the hobbies. And every year we come out with, multiple new variations of this. Some prototypical trains like the new Kansas City Southern Tier 4 freight there. Some a little bit more whimsical, like our NASA Space Explorer set or the Hallow's Eve train there at the bottom that has a lighted boxcar and a number of other fun features on it. And these sets all come with the Bluetooth control. You can either run them with their included remote control, or now you have these apps you can download and run with your phone or even voice control. And a lot of value. Steam locomotives all have working smoke in them. You get lights, you get sounds, a lot going on in these sets. Very easy to set up. And if you're just getting started in the hobby, these are really a nice size for younger hands, easy to get on the track. The track snaps together and stays locked together very nicely and sets up well on pretty much any kind of floor surface. And you get a lot of years of play out of these if you take a little care in them. You'll be turning these down to your kids and grandkids. Like the Lionels you inherited, right? Next up, we've got 75 years of American Flyer. There are a whole catalog of new American Flyer items, rolling stock, some special sets. The USRA Pacifics are returning this year after a long, long hiatus. These will come with our legacy control system, smoke, all the bells and whistles and sounds, wonderful scale, S-scale locomotives. And then the core of our S-gauge line is still the throwback to the original Gilbert American Flyer trains. Older style, that classic toy train design, but also still always some new innovations and keeping up with things. This year we've got our first American Flyer Christmas music boxcar. So in addition to being a Christmas-themed car, which is always our best seller in American Flyer, we've got one that will play Christmas music on your layout. And then also the Bat Signal Batman car, Searchlight car, I think is one of those fun ones. Even if you're a rivet counter, there's some cars that would just be fun to have. And to me, that's one of them. So I've got one more quick announcement to make, Ken. And I don't know if I don't think you were even ready for this one.
Oh, boy.
I can't really get into too many details on it just yet.
Oh, boy.
We will be having a special announcement of another special run locomotive coming out in the next couple of days. So when I'm back here next week, I'm sure we're going to have something very fun and interesting to talk about. This is as much as I was allowed to share tonight under penalty of many, many bad things from Mike Phillips. So,
wow.
We're teasing it up a little bit for you here and hope that we'll get some good buzz going for next week.
Well, Ryan,
you can take Mike Phillips.
Be like that. That's it, Ryan. You left me off with a little teaser. Unbelievable. We're just going to have to wait for the next time you're going to be on. And I believe I should have this date. And I'm actually looking now.
It should be February 4th. We'll be on here again and having some fun. So.
We're going to do a catalog preview flip through because Ryan, you guys just have so much product and a lot of great stuff, and we can't get it all in this small time frame. But you know, you hit some key items right now between the Acela, the Vision Line loco, and now you got this this teaser on us. Man, Mike knows what he's doing. He doesn't want to keep us going.
Absolutely, and I want to mention too, as a nice transition here, we've got some great items in here that we developed with the help of Angela. Some really cool things. A wonderful new accessory that I really love, with the kids looking in the window of a store with an operating model train display inside the store. One of my favorite things in the catalog, and she really helped bring that to life. So I wanted to pitch that up to her, and can't wait to go through this in more detail with you. We do it all tonight, but I don't want to keep Andy up past his bedtime. So with that, I'll shut up and let you go on to the next folks.
That's great. Thank you so much, Ryan. And I think Mike set you up to be the fall guy. Everybody's going to hate you that you didn't spill the beans.
So, I had him scared that I might let it go, but I walked it back. We're all right.
There you go. And we're going to let Andy wait one more time. And since Ryan already was talking about Angela Trotta-Thomas, some of the new items in the catalog, and they actually do look great. So we're excited about that. And we're going to go over to Angela. And Angela, how you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
All right. We missed you.
Thanks. I'm really happy that you're doing this, Ken, because it's so nice to be able to reach out and, you know, talk about this hobby during this time. So thank you very much.
Always our pleasure, Angela. We did the Christmas Angela Trotta-Thomas spectacular together, and it was spectacular. I loved it. Everybody
was spectacular, Ken. Thank you very much. Really, thanks.
No problem. So, what do you got for us tonight?
Well, ironically, guess what I got yesterday in the mail?
Ah, there you go.
So I actually had it all paged out so that we could show a few of the new things here. Let's see. There we go. Can you see the Angela Trotta-Thomas, the the two boxcars. We're starting a brand new series of iconic engines, and the engines are going to be the whole side of the boxcar, which I absolutely love. I'll hold it up again and see if I can get it a little bit better. So you can see the artwork goes across the whole car. And then these are the prints
that
are done with the same artwork. So I'm going to be offering the prints, and you're going to be selling, hopefully, the box cars.
Okay. All right. Very cool.
Basically, I was going to talk a little bit about that. Oh, then I might as well show you the thing that the hobby store that Ryan was talking about. And I have all the artwork at this page, too, which is fabulous. There we go. It's the hobby store with Santa Claus on the side of the hobby store. And that's also available. They're all the artwork is available as a print as well.
Yeah, let me, I'm just going to share my screen, Angela. Here's the, your hobby store that you're talking about. And that looks really neat.
It is really neat. And if you look down on the, below that, you see the side, and it's kind of like a mural that would be painted on an old, building of Santa actually holding the steam engine. And I was delighted to work with this project. This turned out to be such a fun project. I really think it came out really, really well. I'm really pleased with it.
That nostalgic feeling, you know?
I agree. And all the other pieces there's some new ones there as well. Now, I don't know, can you turn the page back to the other? I don't know if you can, let's see what page that was. 128? If that's too hard, then don't worry. No, you're going the wrong way, the other way.
128?
128.
You're just going to hang on 1 second. Lionel's got a huge catalog.
I know. And I'm so happy to be in it. I really am. I really enjoy creating these projects with
Here it is.
You can hear that. Now, those are the pieces that are going to be part of the iconic series. And it's going to be, in fact, we're working on one now with a GG1 on the side. That'll probably be in the next catalog that comes out. But I'm just so pleased with the way they turned out. I just think they turned out great. I'm really happy with them, and excited to see them, in your stuff. So definitely.
Now too.
What was that?
People are collecting your boxcars too, as like a series, not just a one-off. So it's really become a thing.
I know, and I still can't believe it, but I'm really very, very proud of that and pleased that they're enjoying these pieces and that we're able to expand into some other product and just some other series. And I'm just delighted that, people have responded, that and I'm very grateful. I really am. So I wanted to, obviously bring that up. I'm glad you had that, and talk about the prints that if you're interested in any of the artwork, if you go on my website, which is my name, AngelaTrottaThomas.com, and there's a link for Lionel Train limited edition prints. And you click on that and you'll see all the different prints that I have available of a lot of these pieces. I'm so pleased that I would paint the paintings no matter what. The fact that they've ended up on product is just such a wonderful bonus for me, and I'm so grateful. And I thank you all for enjoying them enough to buy them. So I hope they look really good. I'm into color. I obviously, you can see that I like the colorful pieces. So they pop in right off the layout. So I enjoy doing them. I'll keep doing them as long as you keep liking them. So in the background, I have some new work too. This obviously is not a train, but one of the things I wanted to talk about is I do a lot of private commission work, and this is a private commission I'm working on now. It's not finished,
still have obviously all the grass to finish and some detail on the cars and the people. But I really, what I found, that the artwork that I've done for the last 30 years has now transferred into a lot of private commission work where people want me to paint their memories of their toy trains or their memories. This man obviously is a car collector. He's a train collector as well. And they've enjoyed having the artwork, and they want themselves or their family or their memory in it. And so that in itself is really a bonus for me. I couldn't be more pleased. Some of the other pieces on the back, I don't know if you can see them. Also, one of the things I wanted to mention on the prints is these prints do not have to be framed. They're all finished off on the side and the back and can be hung this way. So obviously they take less room. So there's more room for trains on the wall, because I hear a lot of times that there's no more wall space. So we don't have to worry about a frame anymore.
Now, Angela, when you say prints, is that a digital print?
This is a canvas G-clay. And I say G-clay. I often say it because people don't know what it is, but they're the highest end prints that you can get in the in a canvas piece like this in the industry today. And that this is what this is. So I obviously send this artwork out, and it's printed on actual canvas, similar to the canvas that I would work on, and then it's actually wrapped. Mm-hmm. They call this a canvas wrap.
It looks like you painted it. I mean, I could see the fresh paint. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it really they do a beautiful job on these, and they turn out really great. And what's nice about these is, like I said, they do have hooks in the back. You can hang them, or you can set them behind the trains on the shelf. There's, you know, they're very lightweight, so it's not like you have to worry about a frame with glass or whatever, you know, with weight and everything. They're very lightweight, and they just make such a nice statement. This piece, you know, can be behind shelf. Let's see. There.
Beautiful.
And these are big. This is 36 inches wide. So I have different size prints as well. But that's one of the things I wanted to mention. They are finished off as well. So anyway, and one other thing that people like to do when they do their private commission paintings is I do offer the option of getting some prints for personal use for their families. So if, you know, grandpa wants to do a painting of himself as a little boy and he wants to pass it down to three different children, grandchildren, we can get three prints made, and they'll have the image. It won't be the original, but they'll have the image. So that is an option as well to add on to private commission. So let me talk about the private commissions just a little bit. What people mostly do for me is they send me photographs of themselves and their trains, and then I put it together and
wow,
painting out of it. And this is pretty much one of the things that I get a lot of. I get a lot of photographs. This was a little black and white photograph of this man, and he wanted him with one of his favorite engines and also his dream house, which he has today. So this is how we work this one out. So pretty much it can be anything you want it to be. The memory can be whatever you want it to be. Same with this one. Sorry, the lighting is not great. I apologize, but I think you get the idea. So what I usually tell people about my private commission work is call me. My phone number is on my website. Again, it's AngelaTrotaThomas.com. And we can talk about your ideas and put something together that brings back those feelings of, you know, you with your trains when you were little, or it can be your grandchildren. It can be whatever you want it to be, or your children. Doesn't matter. Ken's got one in his hand right now. I see.
I mean, your talent is just unbelievable. I mean, look at this. We're actually going to be framing this in our office, and it's going to go up in our space, and it's just gorgeous. And just the iconic Lionel trains when, you know, your grandfather or father had them back in the day, good old post-war trains. And James, you got to add this for your collection, James.
Oh, I'm already getting ideas for a commission.
The beauty of the commissions is they can be anything. They can be your favorite train. They can be your favorite trains on the shelves. They can be your favorite train with a picture of you. I mean, I've done even, you know, current portraits. This was one.
Wow.
You see, so it can be anything you want it to be. I can't seem to, or there we go.
Angela, so I was thinking about when I first got introduced to trains by my great grandfather, you know, I was thinking about a commission of like 611, which is one of the locomotives we saw when we were little in the 80s. You know, me and my cousin and my great grandfather, you know, just shot from behind of us as a little 8-year-old. So I'll have to get you some photos and we'll have to get that underway.
Yeah, the thing about it is you can email me. My email is angelatrotterthomas@gmail.com. You can email me pictures. And I the way I explain it to everyone is you give me the puzzle pieces and I'll figure out how to put the puzzle together. And I will tell you what I need. I'll walk you through it. You know, I've got it fine-tuned now to a really easy process. So feel free to shoot me emails and anyone. And, you know, we'll just talk about your ideas and see if it might work for you. That would be great. And yeah, anything you could pull together. I don't know if you have pictures of your great grandfather, you said?
Yeah, we've got pictures. He lived up until 2004, so we've got some good photos of him.
Oh,
probably have to do a little freelance on getting all three of us from behind, but I've got lots of photos, you know, of our stance and things like that derive from.
I've manipulated things to make them work in a painting. That's not a problem. I just need, you know, the nuts and bolts pieces to put the painting together the right way.
I've got a big new office I got to put some stuff up on, and they already hear I like trains, so might as well put some stuff in there.
Well, I've got lots of things, lots of paintings and prints, so feel free to call me anytime, James.
I think that's the coolest thing, that you could take pictures of people's memories and, you know, just paint that and imagine that and create it. You're just so talented, Angela, and you truly are the artist of the train industry and many more. I mean, it's just amazing what you create and do for with Lionel and your paintings. It's just really nice stuff.
I've been doing this with Lionel now. It's 30 years. It's pushing 31, actually. So I it's been wonderful. And I have a wonderful relationship with them, and I treasure it. I truly do. Any questions, anyone?
No questions. You're getting some interest, but I think they're a little more personal questions. So you could always email her at her email address or go to her website for if you're looking for pricing and stuff like that. Just reach out to Angela personally. But beautiful stuff. Beautiful stuff.
Right. Just call me and we'll talk first, and then I can figure out all the pricing and all that sort of thing. It really depends on what's going to happen in the painting. I know what time things take me now, because I've been painting these trains for a long time, and I'll take good care of everyone. So please feel free to reach out at any time. I'd love to chat with you or email with you, whatever works for you best.
Yeah, and what's great about your paintings is everybody here has a train room or an office or, you know, a man cave. And, you know, your paintings, you know, just are a wow piece, you know. Well,
the nice thing about the prints is they're not a really highly priced item, and they can give a feel and a flavor to a space like that of your favorite things, what means the most to you.
I'm so telling you, Angela, I swear this is painted.
No, that's a print.
I swear this is painted. It's just unbelievable. I don't know. For me looking at it, It looks like it's a oil-based acrylic paint. I know nothing about painting, but if I was in an art gallery, I would pay a lot of money for this.
Well, thank you very, very much. I have a lot of them available in a lot of different images. I have, you know, the painting here, I don't know if you can really see it that well. That's an original, and the lighting is terrible on it. But I do a lot with real trains as well. So I have, you know, prints on my website with real trains as well. I do so many different things. I work with a gallery here in Charleston, and I do a lot of different kinds of paintings. So I keep busy all the time. Feel free to look through my website, and I think you'll see a lot of different things.
That's great.
Thank you so much, Angela, for doing this. This was such a nice way to reach out, and we really appreciate it very, very much.
You're the best, and we truly appreciate it. And this picture is just means the world to me, and I really appreciate it. And it's just beautiful. So thank you so much for everything you do for the industry.
Oh, I love it. Thank you, and thank you everyone for enjoying the artwork over the years. I'm really appreciate it. Thanks a lot, Ken.
That's great. Thank you so much, Angela. She's so down to earth. Love her so much. And now, last but not least, which Andy's going to kill me for, he's been patiently waiting, and I thought he was going to hang up on us, but I figured if there was some kind of news, it would probably be a blockbuster ending news situation, but we'll see what Andy's got in store for us.
Well, thank you, Ken. I mean, I do have some blockbuster news at the end of my segment, but it probably won't be as blockbuster as you'd really like. I do have a few things to announce at the end that we haven't talked about yet. And so you probably don't know about them. It's possible that my counterpart, who is not here, Rich Foster, spilled the beans. If he did,
that annoys me.
What happened? Well,
Rich,
he's been out all week. His wife was not feeling well, and his daughter, and he was thinking that maybe they had the COVID, and so they got tests and were awaiting results. Now, I think it was just bogus. He was simply not willing to come into work and do this program tonight, and the more I think about it, the more I'm subscribing to that fact.
That's what he told me, Andy.
What did he tell you? That he didn't want to come in here and do that.
He said, Andy go on tonight. Yeah. I'm done. Yeah.
Well, let me tell you, he's not as dumb as he looks because it's really cold in here. We're in a part of near our library, well, what used to be the library, and there's no heat in here, and my toes are cold. I'm shivering. I can't keep my hand still. And it's not because I've been drinking, because I haven't, unlike Ryan. I know now why he did it. This COVID thing was BS. He simply didn't want to sit here and freeze. And it's actually kind of appropriate that is why he's not here, because this being Amherst week, there was a time when he and I were there that he nearly expired on the streets of Springfield, Massachusetts, because it was so cold that he couldn't go on any further. In fact, his words to me were, and admittedly we had dinner and one or two libations, but his words to me were, Andy, I can't go any further. We had to walk about three blocks, just so you know. I can't go any further. My back is hurt. And to his credit, he did have a bad back at the time. And he leaned up against a building, and it was so cold. It was like 15 below zero. It was so cold. And he goes, save yourself, man. Go on without me. So I started to walk away from him. And then I stopped and I said, you know what? He and I have known each other since eighth grade. We've worked together for 30, 40 years, whatever, a long time. Went to college together, high school together. I just couldn't leave him there. I mean, it was tempting because I was cold, but I could walk. He couldn't. I didn't carry him, but I did have to help him along. Anyway, being in this warehouse, I'm freezing, and now I know why. It's Amherst week,
And I wish I was at the show. I wish there was a show. I miss all these guys that are that have come on tonight. It's always a lot of fun doing shows, and it's one of the big things that I've treasured over the last 40 years in the industry and 31 here at MTH. So anyway, it's kind of appropriate that I'm freezing my butt off, albeit in Columbia, Maryland, instead of Springfield, Massachusetts.
Just to let you know, Andy, I think there's a, it's either Rich Foster or Foster impersonator.
Yeah, he likes to post. That's typical of him. You know, he's at home having a few libations, and I guarantee you, he's enjoying this conversation and enjoying not being here tonight, freezing with me. So anyway, I'll see him tomorrow when he rolls back in here. So anyway, enough of that. Obviously he doesn't have COVID, so that's good. His wife does not, his daughter does not, and he'll probably have a cold tomorrow because I guess she is sick, and then he'll come and infect us. You know, one of the nice things about, if there is a nice thing about this coronavirus, is that we've all been protecting ourselves with social distancing, wearing masks, and I haven't been sick in a long time now. That's a good thing, right? So if he comes in here tomorrow and pollutes the office and gets me sick, I'm going to be ticked off. So I better wear a mask.
Rich is throwing some shade at you. Drop some weight in your jacket, my man.
Yeah.
This is going,
that's
right. It's out
Rich.
Really quick.
Yeah, yeah. All right, that's good for him. Well, as everybody knows, you know, things are transitioning here at MTH Electric Trains in our 41st year. Last year was our 40th anniversary, and 2021, I still call it 2020 because 2020 was a terrible year, and it hasn't gotten any better this year with this virus. So to me, it's still just 2020. And we're still on track to be out of this building here at end of May. And I've been going around and kind of documenting the changes that are here. It's rather sad. I'll put together a nice video that'll bring a tear to everybody's eye and feel sorry for Andy. Not so much Rich, but everybody will feel sorry for me when they see how different this place looks. But that'll be down the road, no time soon. Just something to do in my spare time. I'll have a lot of it. Anyway, as far as the company goes, we've been busy, if anybody's been paying attention to our e-newsletters. And before I touch on some of the things that we've announced this month and why we're doing that, it's important to point out that some of the things that are going to get announced within a few months here as we get into the springtime. First and foremost, service work is still ongoing. We're not taking billable service work here any longer. You have to go through our service network, authorized service centers. You can find them on our website. We are in the process of constructing a new parts website. There'll be a new parts business staffed by MTH employees who will be fulfilling parts for sale and for service work through the service centers themselves. That information, that website, I'm not sure exactly when it's going to go live yet, but sometime this spring will be announced as we get really kind of through the winter, get into the first part of spring. And it should be live before we're exiting out of here because they'll be moving all the parts out of here to a new location. Look for that information in addition to the products that we've been announcing to come out sometime early spring. As far as repairs, please do not send any repairs here unless you have got a warranty return authorization number. First of all, part of the problem is our staffing isn't that big here, so the volume could be questionable. It's much better, quicker to go through a service net center rather than sending the product here. And two, with the delivery systems and whatnot, we don't want somebody sending something and then it getting lost in the transition. So it's best to work through the service center. So I encourage you to do that. If you have questions, certainly you can call our service department and get the skinny from them. But don't just willy-nilly send stuff to us out of fear that, oh, we're going to be not able to service product, because that still will happen through the service network. And we just don't want your train to get lost. So that's important to do. Now, one of the things that I wanted to touch on is if you've been subscribing to the newsletter, and Ken, I know you've taken advantage of some of these opportunities here. We've been announcing new products, and everybody's going, "Well, what's going on? Your last products were announced last summer. Why are you announcing new things?" Well, as it is, production is a little behind overseas, and we're going to be getting product that we cataloged in the 2020 Volume 2 book past the time that we have to be out of this building. As you know, we've owned this building for 20 years, sold it last winter, early spring, and we're leasing it back, but we have to be out of here in May. So we're going to have product that's coming in from the 2020 Volume 2 catalog that won't be in here in time for us to get it turned around and shipped out to the consumer. So we're going to have a temporary location for that kind of stuff. And we decided, you know what, we've got product that's coming in. After that point in time when we're out of here, we might as well build some more stuff. So that's what we're doing. And we started announcing items right after the first of the year. And I'll touch on some of those. Some of them are pretty darn hot. We talked about G-Gauge here tonight, and there is some G-Gauge in these items. So we'll touch a little bit on that. Let me just jump over here and pull up some video of some of the stuff that we're doing. So the Premier O-Scale Big Boy has been a huge thing for MTH over the years. And last year we released the Restoration 4014. And that locomotive just took off. We were out of them so quickly it wasn't even funny. And we decided, you know what, let's do that again. And we will build it both in the original or version, the coal version, and the restoration version. And we'll do it in G-Gauge as well. So what I've got is a quick little video here that shows that locomotive in the Premier version. This is the one that we did last year. And it's got that glossy paint scheme that... you can actually, nobody is seeing any of this. Let's see. There we go. My bad. So this is the Premier version. It's available in 4014 restoration, which is the oil burner with the Big Boy chalk markings and the semi high gloss finish that the restoration engine had. And it's got the tender markings on the back of it. It's enhanced the deco inside the cab, as well as all of the standard markings that showed up on that restoration engine. In addition to that, we're doing, and I'm not showing it in this clip, we're doing the coal version. And that coal version will have the satin finish that you are normally accustomed to seeing in our Premier O-Scale line, as well as obviously a coal load. What I'm not showing here as well is the G-Gauge model, but we'll be doing the G-Gauge model in both schemes, the restoration version, coal version, with the high gloss restoration finish, as well as the coal version with the satin finish. So those locomotives are due out after we're out of here. When we talk about G-Gauge Big Boys, Ken, you can attest to this. They're huge boxes, so I'm not sure how Mike is going to manage this in terms of where those products are going to be and how we transition them out to the retailers. We'll be doing it, and look for the G-Gauge engines to arrive August, September, and the Premier O-Scale engines in August, July, August, sometime in that frame.
Yeah. Andy. And,
yes, sir.
And these customers, everybody out there, if you didn't order a Big Boy yet, order this week.
Because
one of the G-Scale numbers, I just had to deactivate this morning. We ordered extra to, you know, plan ahead because sales were going crazy. And it's just unbelievable. We're going to be sold out very quickly. So if you didn't order an O-Scale or G-Scale, do it within the week because I got to make them non-active. And Rich always hates when I call him up and try to squeeze him more when he's got he has no more.
Well, and, you know, here's what I want you to do, Ken. Obviously, he's been busting my butt tonight on your chat comments. So you feel free to call him up and bust his chops tomorrow or whenever. But Ken is absolutely correct, folks. Don't wait to order these engines. They are going to be sold out. In fact, most of the product that I'm talking about tonight will, in fact, sell out very quickly. We're not going to be inventorying anything. As I explained, we've got a space problem coming up here this spring and summer. So we've got to turn that merchandise. Once it comes in, it needs to get inspected and turned around to the retailers that have it on order. So if you see anything that you like tonight or that you've seen announced in the newsletters the last couple of weeks, get it on order because it won't be around after the fact.
Yeah,
absolutely correct. So
it's funny, Andy, because even on the O scale big boy, on the original version, I think Mike originally for the first day only made 50 units, and over that night we sold over 25 pieces.
Yeah.
so and then we were getting, you know, death threats and a lot of angry customers saying that we wanted more units.
Right.
So
right.
It was like crazy. And, thankfully, Mike and your team, you know, opened up the orders again and gave it another couple of days for people to get their orders in. But it's just incredible, the demand and, you know, people wanting the last of the MTH product. So, you know, crazy stuff.
Yeah. No, you're absolutely right. It is amazing how, you know, when people realize that something is interesting and hot. And I think part of the problem, Ken, is that, you know, when that big boy came out last year, we didn't make enough of them. There was no question about it. Mike's been very conservative with the production numbers the last couple of years. And, you know, most, I would say 75% of the product that comes in here is pre-sold. There's no inventory to be had. Makes my job a little easier because there's less product to promote, but you know, you're leaving money on the table is what ends up happening because the demand is just higher than what you're guessing when you're being that conservative. And I think that big boy announcement was a good example of that. And we were fortunately had time to adjust, and I think people will be super happy with it. Still in a big number, and people will treasure them for years. For sure. And it's just a beautiful piece. For sure. The other item that we announced, actually, I think it was the week after that, was the BNSF 25th anniversary ES-44. And this locomotive just came out on the railroad as part of BNSF's celebration of their heritage railroads. And we're doing six different cab numbers. There's more than that in this scheme, but some of the models don't quite jive with our model's detail, so we elected not to do them. But Spokane, Portland, Seattle, Colorado and Southern, Frisco, Santa Fe, Burlington Northern, Northern Pacific, Great Northern, and Burlington Route are the railroads that are represented on this scheme. And we're doing the six different cab numbers. I think they'll flash up here. These engines are selling super well. And I think we may have even closed orders on that. I'm not quite certain if that's the case. But yeah. If it's
and,
not,
and
it'll
the,
be
in. Your number one sales guy today just sold all of them to a big dealer in New York. So, but you guys didn't have a lot left. He actually squeezed me in for ones or twos on certain numbers. But these actually, it's another example of, you know, it's one of your last diesel engines. And I don't think anyone's really made this in old scale. It's a brand new, you know, paint scheme. So just really popular, and it's going to be hot.
Yeah, no, for sure. And I'm glad to see that that sales guy is doing his job, because most of the time he doesn't, you know, kind of rolls in here about 10:30 every morning. It's good life. Good to be Rich Foster.
We did a iPhone, one of those virtual calls. And he was on the golf course today.
No, he wasn't on the golf course today. It was too cold. I played golf a couple of weeks ago, and that was a mistake. But I know that's not the case. So no worries there. So last week we announced a Rail King SW15, SW1. So this is a Rail King scale locomotive, and we're doing this in 6 different paint schemes. This locomotive, as I said, is Rail King scale. A lot of people don't really understand what that means. And essentially it's that these are 1/48 scale locomotives that will look at home with any Premier item. So don't be afraid of the Rail King banner on the box. These locomotives look great with any scale piece. And they're just like our high-end engines where you've got twin motors, you've got ProtoSound 3, they pull well, they've got die-cast trucks, a stamped metal floor, die-cast fuel tank. So they're super good pullers and got all the LED lighting, everything you'd find in Premier, with the exception of, you know, all the separate relief that you might normally see on the side of a cab, or maybe operating smoke because there's not enough room inside, those kind of things. But you know, bottom line is great engines to get, selling well already. And again, it's one of these things where I think people are going out and they're kind of freaking because this is the end of some of the MTH products, and you know, they don't want to miss out. So Train World can certainly handle your order there, and or any MTH authorized retail. I got to give some props to my other guys as well. Though they don't do the job that Ken does when it comes to promoting this hobby. You really, you know, I've said it to you before, you really deserve all the credit in the world for taking
Andy,
the effort to do
it. This was your idea. Remember it.
Well, I appreciate that you reminded me of that because I remind myself of that all the time. But yeah, I do appreciate that. That's very kind of you to say. It was a darn good idea. No doubt about it.
Yes.
Okay. So folks that have subscribed to the newsletters, today we had another new announcement, and I want to talk about this a little bit to make sure that people understand what's going on with this next product. This is our Rail King Scale F3, and the one thing about the Rail King Scale F3 is that, like the SW1 that we just saw, it is in fact a scale locomotive, but this is really plays off of the Lion-L original F3, which a lot of people don't realize was also a scale size locomotive. And the other thing about this engine in several of the paint schemes, including this Santa Fe Warbonnet, is that we're doing the locomotive with that high gloss red finish and stainless plated bodies. And it's unfortunate that you don't see that in these pictures. One of the interesting things about our company is, and I mentioned it, kind of alluded to it earlier, when the product is selling as quickly as it typically does, we don't always get to document the production runs. And so I don't have any good pictures of the Santa Fe Warbonnet that we've done in the past with that plated finish. But that's, the way this engine will come, as well as a Burlington version, as well as the matching passenger cars that you're seeing flashing up on the screen. Now, obviously, we're looking at the B&O Railroad right now, and that won't have a plated finish, but this Burlington will. And again, you can't really tell in these pictures, but if you've gone to our site and looked at any of our Premier Alco PAs, that's a good example. You can see those videos online. They, in fact, have the plated finish. So go check that out at our YouTube channel, and you will be able to see that plated finish. That's what you can expect on these Santa Fe and Burlington F3s. The last one that flashed up there, and I should have given myself a little bit more time, was the EMD demonstrator. MTH has done a lot of demonstrator paint schemes over the years for different manufacturers, whether it be EMD, General Electric, Alco, even Fairbanks Morris. We've done demonstrator schemes, and they've always been very, very popular. Some of them were done as part of our old dealer appreciation package, and been super hard to find, quite rare. That paint scheme that flashed up there is a demonstrator scheme that we did way back in 1998, I believe. And it was done we called it a Rail King F3, but it was really our Rugged Rail F3. It was the Shorty F3 that we stick in our train sets. We never did it in the Rail King scale F3. We've certainly done it in Premier, but not the Rail King scale F3. So that's a first for that paint scheme. And, you know, it's one of the things that is typical of our company when we've done so many different SKUs. When we got through our 2020 volume two book, we had about 33,000 items in our history over the last, you know, 40 years. And it's easy to forget things that you should do again or that you didn't do. And this EMD demonstrator scheme is a perfect example of that in the Rail King line. You would have thought we'd have done it a long time ago. And yet we did not. And you know, I have to put the blame on myself. Mike can't remember all of that. I should probably do a better job of going through that. But, you know, you can only do so much, right? So anyway, here's a great opportunity for us to right a wrong, if you will, in terms of not having done that paint scheme again. Because all the other demonstrator schemes for the EMD F3s, we've done. So this is a good opportunity to fix that. And these were just announced this Wednesday. In addition to this Wednesday, we also announced some Christmas items. We're rerunning the diesel ES44 Christmas locomotive and caboose sets. We've got some Christmas items still in stock from last year, and we're rerunning some other items. If you go to mthtrains.com, one of the rotating banners on the front page will be an article about the Christmas items that that we're doing this year and that are in stock. So take a gander at that, and you'll be able to see what's coming and what we did last year that we're redoing this year. So one last chance at doing more Christmas stuff. Always been a lot of fun for us. Our graphic designers have always enjoyed creating some of those cars and locomotives. So that's a good example of being able to do that. So that was in this past Wednesday's announcement. Again, every week for the next few weeks, we'll be announcing new things. One of the things that I want to take a look at right now are two more items that we have not announced. And again, Ken, you may know about this. Rich was sworn to secrecy, but sometimes he forgets who swore him to secrecy. And he may have already told you this. So if you're not surprised, let me know, because I know who to talk to. Just saying.
Rich, I false. Think I'm going to be surprised. He really didn't tell me anything.
He didn't tell you anything. Okay. All right.
What a salesman.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. So we're going to be rerunning, and we haven't done it this way before, the GE ES44 diesel caboose set in our Rail King Imperial line. And this locomotive we've done before, but we've never done it with a matching bay window caboose. We did a separate sail caboose before, but it wasn't a bay window. This has the charging lights, and it's been a great seller for us, so this is an opportunity to get one more of those. And then, like the Premier ES44 25th anniversary BNSF, we're doing that in the Rail King Imperial line as well. In addition to the locomotive and caboose, we'll also be announcing double door, 50-foot double door boxcars with special 25th anniversary livery to match up to the locomotive and caboose, so you can build your own BNSF 25th anniversary set with those items. I think there are five or six 50-foot double door boxcars. The designs aren't done on those yet, so we'll probably push that announcement off for a couple more weeks and promote the locomotive and caboose again. So there's nothing in the order system for you to start placing your orders. I don't even have the item numbers other than what you just saw flash up handy, because I've forgotten them already. And so call Rich in the morning and say, what are those item numbers, so you can start your promotions, because undoubtedly people are going to call you up and want to get those. And we'll be doing formal announcements of those locomotive sets over the next couple of weeks. So did he tell you about that?
No, he didn't tell me. And I think we should give out Rich Foster's cell phone so he could start taking orders, because he didn't tell anyone to take pre-orders.
Well, in his defense, he may not have known I was doing... Well, no, I shouldn't say that. Ken, as you know, when I do these presentations, I have a fairly lengthy outline with all kinds of notes in it and so forth. I've provided that to you, you know, because I like to help you out a little bit while you're guiding a conversation along. Well, I give those to Rich all the time too. And so when Rich and I are normally doing this thing, and again, he'd normally be sitting right next to me. He comes up, he puts on his headphones, hooks up his microphone and goes, oh, I forgot my notes. And then he runs back to his office while we're counting down to go on the air. And he sits down and he's never read the notes. So why even bothered to bring them? I don't know. And there's all kinds of relevant data in those notes about the product, you know, salesmanship kind of stuff that a good salesman would have. Anyway, so he did know about those engines. He knew that I was going to talk about those tonight. But he probably didn't know because I'm sure he did not read the notes. Now,
want to tell you, this is the conversation that the back and forth with you and Rich go behind the scenes. So you'll send out an email on new products, and I, in turn, print it out, and I go, what the hell is this? Then I call Rich, and Rich goes, what the hell is Andy doing? Well, so it's a little circle that we all go back and play, but it's all good because we end up getting them online somehow.
Well, Rich is the only one that doesn't know about it. You know, that's really the key there. He knows, but he forgets, and that's really the problem. You know, and I think it's
Andy's on top of the food chain.
There's that. I mean, you know, Rich is, it's a senility issue, frankly. I mean, let's face it. He's getting older. He's going to be 60 in a year, and as will I, unfortunately. But I'm much sharper. So, anyway, one last item, and this may rain on Mr. Ryan Kunkel's parade. And I only say that because that thing he wouldn't let out of the bag earlier, he showed some graphics behind the blacked out engine, and it made me think that maybe what I'm about to announce is in fact what he is going to announce. And maybe not. Maybe I'm wrong, but that's my guess. And if it is, I'm sorry, Ryan. And I won't tell Mike Phillips that you told me what you were building. So that, you know, you can keep your, oh, sorry. Anyway, I'm just kidding, Mike. So we'll see. Maybe I'm right. Maybe I'm wrong. But this was my guess. And this is going to be announced in another week or two. And this is the SD70 diesel caboose sets, again in the Rail King Imperial line. And these are celebrating the Montana Rail Links specialty essential workers and veterans trains that they have rolled out. Beautiful paint scheme, super American oriented, you know, make you feel good about the country and all that stuff. So anyway, Ryan, maybe he can weigh in after we're done here and tell me whether I spilled the beans or not. But these will be out June of 2021. And again, there'll be order cycles opening up here sometime in the next week or so. And Rich will, of course, let you know all about that, Ken, when he gets back into the office.
When he gets back, that's amazing. A lot of good stuff, Rich. Andy, I got Rich in my head that I'm calling you Rich.
Yeah, no, that's okay. You know, I'm better looking, but it's okay. So anyway, yeah, he'll be back in. So make sure you give him a call and get that process rolling. And the consumers can expect to see, as I said, additional promotions on that through our newsletters. And, you know, by all means, folks, if you haven't signed up for those newsletters, there's still a ton of information coming out. We talk about the auctions that have been going on with our archives and so forth in those newsletters, and some spotlights of product, and there'll be more announcements as we go along. So just go to mthtrains.com, click on the newsletter link, sign up for it. It's free, and you can keep abreast of whatever's happening with us as we move through the rest of this transition.
That's great, Andy. And this is like bittersweet.
Well, we keep saying that, and then we keep doing these things. And, you know, I enjoy doing them. And, you know, I've been in this for a long time. And it certainly made a lot of friends with folks and customers. And, you know, I've enjoyed it. And you know, I was talking about the Amherst week and all of that. One of the things that I don't miss about Amherst is always missed my son's birthday. He'll be 27 tomorrow, and be about every 3 years I'd get his birthday because it would fall Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday of the week. And then I'm on the road Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday for Amherst. And he used to really give me a lot of grief about that. Understandably so. I mean, you know, he was a little kid. And his dad wasn't home for his birthday. And I think he punished me because he never got into trains. Or I just wore him out by bringing him in on Saturdays and making him play in the layout room and run trains and, you know, basically keep himself busy while I did work. One of those two things, either the birthday, me not being around because I was at a train show, or forcing trains on him when he was a young kid. The hobby never stuck with him. But he's a good kid, and I say that. He's a man. He's got a kid. I got two grandkids, so that's what this hobby's done for me, and I certainly appreciate it, and appreciate everything that you've done, and continue to support you guys as we go forward, and look forward to seeing you again when this daggone COVID thing is over.
Well, that's great, Andy, and at least you know you get to spend some time with your kids and families, and sometimes that's most important. So,
oh, no doubt, no doubt, no doubt at all. So.
Andy, my wife said that she will find you no matter where you go, because
she's going to hunt me down.
Yeah, I just spent an unmentionable amount of money with one gauge aces and SP4449 and a big boy and a Challenger that I chased down. So, and then all the passenger cars I was chasing down and that have been off the market, because I don't know how I would go to these train shows every year and see this stuff at your booth, and it never sunk in. And then all of a sudden I fall in love as it's on its way to exit stage left. But yeah, my wife said she's got a bone to pick.
Well, yeah, you can tell your wife, James, that she'll have to get in line, because there's a lot of women that have a bone to pick with me for doing that very same thing, amongst other things too, probably, but for sure the train side.
Yeah, Ken's happy because I think he can buy a new car off the profits, but my wife is not happy.
Understood. My apologies.
All right. Well, great show. Action-packed. James, I don't know if you want to do a recap around the horn, but just so much new stuff, new product. Everybody's announcing new catalogs. Just really good stuff.
Yeah, just amazing, especially just beginning into G-scale a little bit, to see what's out there and to see different aspects of the hobby, like Angela Trotta Thomas, you know, that being able to capture, you know, a moment in my childhood is something that I'm really interested in doing. So I look forward to working with you. It's always great to hear from Lionel and Bachman. You guys are staples in the industry. Atherin, staple in the industry. A lot of history, MTH, you know, Lionel, I think, was turning, would you say, over 100, Ryan? So just amazing to be able to see where it's come to in just the short time I've been in the hobby. So it's an MTH, man. I'm going to miss you guys, miss Andy's antics during these virtual shows and at the real shows. I hear all sorts of rumors about what goes on after the shows. I just never got around to doing it because I'm editing video.
That they were all true.
And we're going to make them worse when you're gone.
Likely.
but yeah, it's just a great aspect from the G-scale stuff at Pico and LGB. Has a lot of interest, and I know it's going to create a lot of pre-orders, and it's going to keep our wallets pretty empty going forward as modelers. So it's a great privilege to hang out with you guys this evening, and thank you so much for going over all the new products with us.
Great stuff. And if any of you guys have a last minute thing to say before we kick it off.
Thank you again for doing this, Ken.
We really appreciate it very much.
Thanks, Angela.
Thank you, Ken, for everything. Thank you to everybody else who stuck around, and thank you to everybody on Facebook and YouTube who tuned in and watched all this. And of course, none of us would be here doing any of this if it wasn't for Andy and his one good idea. So,
good idea.
So I want to thank you for that, Andy. And no, you didn't let any cats out of the bag, so we'll be okay.
You still have a job. All right, good.
I didn't want you to lose any sleep tonight.
I appreciate that. I wouldn't have, but I appreciate that.
Looks like they already turned the lights off on you in there, so.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll just say goodbye to everybody. Thanks for joining in, and hopefully we'll be here. We'll be at the real show next year. So.
Yep.
Okay. Thanks again, Ken. We do appreciate it, and hope everybody checks out the just right there, America's largest discount train store.
There you go.
Thanks for everything, and James, thanks for co-hosting this. We appreciate it.
Thank you, James. It's kind of weird to say.
James and James.
All right. One other point I wanted to make is, Ken, you put a lot of effort in putting this on, and thanks for all the time and the exposure. I mean, the numbers are just insane when you get all the different platforms together. So thanks for your hard work behind the scene putting this together. I mean, I forgot to mention that yesterday, and I felt bad about it because there's a lot of work involved, and we appreciate you.
No, thank you, James. And I couldn't do it without everybody here tonight. And it's truly a team effort. And that's why these shows are so great, because everyone here, well, Jim, we'll get there. But everyone here, we build these relationships. And whether it was Athens, prior, but we all meet each other. We know each other. And it's a really great feeling. It's of a family. It's a camaraderie. So it's really great to see you guys. And Andy, it's always a pleasure with you. And I'm sure you'll still be in the industry one way or another. But tonight's bittersweet. But thank you guys so much for coming on tonight. And huge numbers. I mean, eyeballs over 1,000 at times. So it's just through all streams. So it's tremendous success. And I couldn't do without all of you guys, and especially you, James. I appreciate you co-hosting this with us. And but there still is more. Tomorrow night, Thursday, 6 p.m., we have Atlas Walther's Broadway, Rapido, Intermountain, Classic Metalworks, and Kado. So stay tuned. There's more to come Thursday. So it's been a whole weekend action-packed virtual train show, the big Train World show. So thank you, everyone out there. We couldn't do it. Manufacturers, dealers, we couldn't do it without your support. So we really appreciate everyone out there joining in tonight. It means the world to everyone. And all these great products you can find at trainworld.com. We're taking pre-orders on all this new stuff that's all announced. If Rich Foster gave me a little leeway, I'd be able to have some MTH product listed on the website. But you know Rich. But thank you guys so much, and have a great night. And we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you guys for joining. Have fun.
Take care.
Bye.